Now that we've looked into creating our own custom filters, I'd be remiss not to mention the filters provided by AngularJS. So let's look at the main filter, which will allow us to search stuff. So I'm going to start from scratch here, so it's kind of blank slate right now. And I'm going to take this data set I have of the Avengers cast, just kind of copy that, and I'll drop it in as a service. So my app factory, we'll call this Avengers. And this will return an Avengers object, and then return it. And then we'll say Avengers cast is this. All right. And then all we're going to do is just create a controller called Avengers controller and set the cast. Set the cast equal to, actually we'll set an Avengers object equal to the Avengers, which I haven't injected yet. So let's add that here. All right. So if you see what's going on, I just created a controller and all we're doing is providing the Avengers model into our scope. And that's all we need to do in our script to set up the service and provide it. So let's set up the controller, and this was Avengers controller. And then we can create a table and loop through that data. So we'll just do a table with row, and then each row we'll use something called ngRepeat, which is one of the most powerful directives that Angular provides to loop through each actor in the Avengers cast. So this will have two columns in it, the first one being the actor's name, and the second one being the actor's character. And again, this is just name and character, mapping to name and character, and Avengers cast is simply the Avengers cast, which is an array of these objects of name and character. All right, so we hit refresh here, and we get a nice list of the name and the character in the Avengers cast. So let's set up a way to search through this using the main filter in Angular. So let's set up an input, the type of text, and the model for this will be just, we'll just say search text. That's generic enough for anybody. And then we'll set up a filter on the ngRepeat instead of the way we did it in our own custom filter. We just kind of modified a string. This time we're going to limit this set. So we'll say filter, and the limiter for it, the model we're passing in, is going to be the search text. So the moment I start typing in here now, so ROB brings me to Robert, CHRI brings me to Chris. You also notice if I type Steve, we're also getting the character as well as the actor name. And the way you'd actually limit that is instead of doing search text, we could do search.name and then filter by the search object. So this would mean it would only limit it. It would limit it to just the name of the actor. So Steve wouldn't work anymore, but Chris still would. So if we wanted to filter by the character, you can see that now Steve will work, but Chris won't. And if you want to do either one, you can just do a dollar sign. And this will show Chris and Steve. So that's the main filter function provided by AngularJS. It takes an object or a string. If it's an object, you can limit what you want to search for by the name of the property, like name or character. Yeah, it'll limit the name or the character, or just the dollar sign for any. If it's just a string, it'll just search everything. And that's the way you can use it. It's pretty straightforward. Not much work here, just most of the work is just copy and pasting. You can see if I collapse that, we only have one service one controller and not a lot going on other than repeating and using one of the awesome filters already provided. We'll go into more filters in the next video.